Hey everyone, it's Will, Gamer Dad, with another video for you. So it's only been a week since that large, massive Goddess of Time Part 3 conclusion update has dropped, and we have yet another update, version 2.9.1. So this is definitely a different version than the current one we're on, which is 2.8.5, and it features ally encounter Garambarrel. So if you've done the conclusion up to chapter 8, you know, even 76, 77, you'll probably have met him on your travels. And for those who find him as a husbando or wanting to add some very powerful tanking titan to your team, then this is the banner to summon on. He is great as a tank. He can do some DPS. He is very strong. So just an overview of some of his moves. Power and Int down dual debuff 25% chance, 25% down, guaranteed for 3 turns, and inflicts pain. So dual debuffers are always in great demand, and so this one is another one that you can add to your team. He is also a Wind Pierce unit that uses a lance, just in case I didn't mention that earlier. Also, he can apply preemptive rage on all enemies and shield himself physical resistance plus 70% for 3 turns and type resist of all party members 35% for 3 turns. So almost like a different, I don't want to say better than Bertrand, but certainly a very powerful tank in that sense. As his passive, when he starts in the front line at the beginning of any battle, he has a 100% damage reduction shield on all frontline members and in the reserve for one move. So essentially, guaranteed survive turn one attacks from super enemies, super bosses, and stuff like that too. Now, the one thing I would say that's different from him and Bertrand is that he can seem to do quite a bit of damage. He's got a Wind Pierce single target XL, and it increases his own max HP and is stackable up to 3,000 plus HP, and that lasts for 5 turns. And depending on how much HP he gets, and you can also add things like max HP badges or Graster or things like that, the damage will increase with his attack. So he can actually do a fair bit of damage, and I would say that's a little bit different from Bertrand. So if you want a hot husbando titan tank, this is the one to summon on. Anyways, on top of all this, there seems to be a new boss rush, aka battle simulator, Duel with the Past. I'm a little bit nervous about this since I haven't even finished the 8 dual Hachio Eastern Spirits. So this is going to be another one on the backlog to work on over the next couple of weeks. That being said, you only have to finish chapter 44 to access this one. But for all of you who have finished, of course, Goddess of Time, then of course this will be accessible for yourself as well. And for those who want to try for Garambarrel, obviously there is the standard paid and free banner, as well as a fateful encounter. I'm wondering if this one is going to be, since it's 3 times max, whether or not he'll be the only one featured, or if they'll have other units featured on this banner as well. Continued increased Chronostones logins until the end of the month, which we're already experiencing. And apparently we get extra bold pulses for those who want to really tackle these battle simulator fights more quickly. And other than that, there are some fixes, because with the for some of you who had started part of the Mark of Beast or Mark of Man's tomb, there are certain events where you couldn't really get the Graster or the rewards from that. So they are looking to fix that in this update as well. So let me know if you're going to plan to summon on Garambarrel, or how far are you in the update, whether or not you're even finished. I'm actually very surprised they dropped this so quickly after the main update, being that I would imagine the vast majority of us haven't finished nearly all the fights as well. For myself, can't decide if I'm going to summon a Garambarrel or if I'm going to pass on this banner. I feel that he would be a welcome addition to my team, but we'll have to see how I feel when the time comes tomorrow night. Anyways, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.